screen share of the this square roots lesson, and we have in this from question number 5 of exercise 6.3. So up to 4 questions we completed in the previous session. So in this session we are going to have from question number 5. So here the concept is that, are you able to see my screen, all of you? Are you
yes,
able
sir.
To, yeah, screen share is happening, right?
Good.
Okay, I am going to open this video.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Just a minute, wait. Right. Yeah, this is what we completed yesterday. From we'll go for prime factorization method is already over, and from this method we will go again. Right. So this is how we find the square root of a number using prime factorization method. Okay. Wait for the screen to open. Your screen is opening now. The prime factorization method. In this method, we prime factorize the given square number first of all, and then find, arrange the primes in pairs. From each pair, one factor is chosen, and the square root of the number is nothing but the product of all the factors chosen. Right? Let us take one example to understand this method. That is, 64 is taken. 64, when divided by 2, 32, divided by 2 again, 16, divided by 2 again, 8, and it is now 2 finally. All these are prime numbers. 2 is a prime number, so we stop the division here and write 64 as product of all the prime numbers here. Only 2 is a multiple here, 2 is a factor here. So 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into, so we got 8
twos,
yeah, 6 twos we have, and 3 pairs of twos. So from each pair I have to choose one. So square root of 64 is 8. This is how we can find out the square root. Another example, more examples we are taking. 225. 225 is 3 into 3 into 5 into 5. Again pairs are taken.
Is the answer, sir.
Huh? Yeah, 225
15.
Is 15. 15
is the answer.
Very good, very good. Now for 400 also we have chosen. All this we
20,
know.
Sir.
Yeah. We know
20,
it.
Sir.
So exercise we started. This one I don't want to show you. This is, we'll go for 16th slide directly. Yeah, 6. Find the square roots of the following by prime factorization method. 1764, that is divided by 2. Again, we got a prime number 7 here. So therefore, it is written as 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 7 into 7. And 1764 is nothing but 2 into 2, 3 into 3, 7 into 7. When paired like this, therefore 1764 is equal to root of square root of 1764 is equal to 2 into 2 into
42.
2 into 3 into 7 is 42. For 4096 also we can find the square root by prime factorization method like this, right? So for two more numbers we did that day, I'll show you those also. So square root of 4096 is 64, and though it is a long process, the division is simple because we are doing in short, we write only the quotients. Right. Here, find the square root of 7744. Right, 7744 is a very good number because 2 sevens and 2 fours, and you can observe this number. divided by 2, then we get 3872. When divided by 2, the quotient is 1936. Again, further division 968. Further, when we divide 484, and then 242, 121, and 121, when 11s are 121, of course, this 11 is not required here. I am going to cut this. Once you get the prime number, we can stop doing all this. Stop doing all this. We can stop. One second. My pen is not starting. Okay. This is not required. You need not write up to ones here. Once you get a prime number, you can say it's a prime number and stop division here itself. And this is the prime number. We can stop the division, short division here. So 7744 can be written as 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 11 into 11. So 2 into 2 into 2 into 11 is taken. So its square root is 88. So here the number is 7744. Its square root is 88. So that is the specialty of this number. So the digits are, two digits are repeated one after another here, 7744. And its square root also is a number with the same digits, 88. So it's a special number. You can remember this. Now 9604 is the next number. When divided by 2, you get 4802. Then, and divided by 2 further, 2401. Now 2401 cannot be divided further by 2 or by 3 or by 5. So we choose 7, next number, next prime number. So when you divide it by 7, you get 343. 343 when divided by 7, it will give 49. So when 49 is divided by 7, it gives 7. And you can further, you need not write this division, it is not required. Here you got a prime number, so we leave this division here itself. It is a prime number. So PN you can write. PN is a short form for prime number. So 9604 is 2 into 2 into 7 into 7 into 7 into 7. 9604 is 2 into 7 into 7, it is 98. So this is how you will find square root of a number using prime factorization method. Now you consider this number 252. 252. Let us prime factorize this number. 2, when you divide it by 2, you get 126 as the quotient. Further division, you get 63. And 63 is not divisible by 2, therefore you take 3, 3, 21.
42 is the answer.
One second, you wait, wait.
42, sir.
Wait, children. 7 is the prime number, so we stop the division here. When you prime factorize 252, it comes like this, 2 into 2 into 3 into 3 into 7. When you arrange them in pairs, 7 is not having a pair, not having a pair. So, when you multiply on both sides by 7, suppose you want to you multiply this number by 7, this side also 7 will be added like this. So, 7 will be there in the product. 7 into 7 we did. Here also one 7 has come this way. So, now, three different pairs of numbers are there. Therefore, you can multiply and its square root is 2 into 3 into 7, 42 now. So, what is the number that should be, that should multiply? By what number we have to multiply 252 to make it a perfect number, perfect square number? It is 7. So, 252 is to be multiplied by 7 to make it a perfect square. Perfect square. Some people like Subham or Saket may say, why should we multiply, sir? I don't want to multiply. Okay, don't multiply. At least divide. At least divide. We divide on both sides by 7. Then the pair will go. Let the factors, prime factors come in pairs. Then what will happen? So on both sides when you divide by 7, this 252 divided by 7 will be giving you 36 as the number here. And here, this 7, here this is the actual prime factorization. When you divide it by 7, 7 and 7 are cancelled. Only the pairs, the factors will come in pairs again. So, for 36 we can square root, you can find out very well, it is 6. So, not only by multiplication, even by division by 7 also will make it a perfect square. So, 252 can be multiplied by 7 and made into a perfect square. Or, it can be divided by 7 and made it a perfect square. Okay, as such 252 is not a perfect square, you know that, because its prime factors are not occurring in pairs. Therefore, to complete the pairs either by multiplication or by division, we do it. Right? Now, let us take one more example of this kind. Take 180. When 180 is divided by 2, it is 90, quotient is 90. Further division will give you 45 as the quotient. 45 cannot be divided by 2, therefore we take 3 as the next prime number. Next prime number 3 divides 45 15 times, and 3 divided by 15, 15 divided by 3 will give you 5, that is a prime number. So we stop the division here and write the prime factorization of 180 like this. 2 into 2.
30, sir.
Into 3 into 3 into 5.
90.
Whereas
square root of 90.
When you divide, when you multiply this one by 5 on both sides, then all the prime factors will be arranged in pairs. Therefore, to make it a perfect square, we multiply by 5. Multiply by 5. Okay.
5.
So, after multiplication by 5, 180 will become 900. Square root of 900 is 30. So, children, did you remember I told you to make a square table and remember the squares up to 25, I think. Up to 25 I told to remember. Did you remember?
Yes, sir.
Square.
I will ask you in between, okay?
Okay, sir.
Keep remembering the squares, square roots. That square root table you should have in your study room somewhere. Right. Let us consider now 1008. When 1008 is when divided by 2, 504 is the quotient, 504 further divided by 2, 252, and when divided by 2, 252 will give you 126 as the quotient, 126 when divided by 2, you get 63 as quotient, then 21 is the quotient when you divide it by 3 further, because 2 cannot divide 63. So, again, 21 can be divided by 3 to get 7 as the prime number here. So, we stop the division as we obtained a prime number as quotient. Further division we don't take. So, then when we have arranged the prime numbers in pairs, 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3, 7 is not having a pair here. Therefore, prime factor 7 does not have pair, therefore we will multiply the number by 7 to have a pair this side. Therefore, all the pairs will be completed and its square root can be found easily. When you multiply by 7, 1008 will become 7056, 7056. And 7056 can be written in the form of pairs, product of primes.
7056 root. Root of 7056 is 84, sir.
84, very good. Who said this?
Tejaswini, sir. Tejaswini.
Tejaswini, good girl, good girl. Right. 7056 will give you the square root of this one is nothing but 84. That's the right answer.
Sir, in prime factorization, we should also include units and units place, means squares and square roots.
Right. Now, next one. Let us take another example of division now. Here, 2645 is taken as our number. When you divide this number by 5, because only 5 will divide this, 2 cannot divide because it is not a even number, and 3 will not divide 2 plus 6, 8 plus 4, 12, 12 plus 5, 17. 17 is not a multiple of 3, therefore 3 also will not divide this number. Therefore, we divide it by 5, the next prime number. when you divide it by 5, you get 529. And remember, this 529 is a very special number. It cannot be divided by any other prime except 23. Up to 23, you go on trying. It will be divided only by 23, because 23 itself is a prime number. 23 multiplied by 23 is 529. So when arranged, the prime factorization, 5 is not having a pair here. So we will divide it by 5 on either side, so that it will become 529 again, and 529 square root is 23. Square root of 529 is 23. So keep children, you have to make a note of all these things quickly. I don't know whether you are noting or not, or at least take screenshots whenever the question comes on the screen. Right? Next question. Shall we move on to the next one now?
Yes, sir.
Sir.
Yes. Now, this
yes,
is,
sir.
This is 2800 I am taking now. When I divide 2800 by 2, I get 1400 as the quotient. 1400 when divided by 2, 700. 700 by 2, 350. 350 by 2, 175. 175 is a multiple of 5 only, not by, you cannot divide it by 3 also, because 3 5s are 15 and 2 25. 25 is not divisible by 3. Therefore, we'll take 5, 5 35s. Again, further by 5, 7 is left out. So, you have to divide on both sides by 7. To make it a perfect
square. So, root of 400 is 20, sir.
Very good, very good. Root of 400 will come here. 2800 equal to 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 5 into 5 into 7. 7 does not have its pair. Therefore, we divide on either side by 7. So that this side it will become 400. This side it will become perfectly 3 pairs will be there. And one factor from each pair we take to get the square root of the remaining number here, that is 420. Now, this is all about
the root of 19,600 is
140,
sir.
Root of
19,600 is 140, sir.
19, yeah.
If we multiply it.
Right. That's right. Now, children, up to here we understood 6 problems so far from the exercise. Now, there are some questions. I discussed the questions using a presentation again for you. I will discuss this. I'll come back to the presentation, normal mode. Normal mode is coming now. Listen, here we go. There are some questions here. I'll read the question. What to be done, let us discuss. And afterwards, we do them on the board, I mean, our this one here, on the whiteboard here. Students of class 8 of a school donated 2,401 rupees in all for Prime Minister's National Relief Fund. Each student donated as many rupees as the number of students in the class. Find the number of students in the class. Here, good thing in the class, in the student, they all donated like this. They have a particular a fashion like this. What is that? Suppose there are 40 children. Each child donated 40 rupees. If 30 children are there, each child donated 30 rupees. Like this, number of children equal to number of rupees donated by each child. So, how many, they are totally, they have donated 2,401 rupees. So, how many children are there, how many students are there in the class is the question here. So, let us do this here on the screen. I will present the screen option for you. One second. See, some are leaving, some are joining. That is, I am observing children here. I am having meet attendance here on my table. That means every 5 minutes I will take the attendance. When I take the attendance, it will give me how many are present at that particular time.
Sir, sir, actually I have been signed with the school account, sir. Before it was Yedavalli Saket, my roll number was there, sir. But now I am using my new one, sir. So I left and I again joined.
But I told, wait, no. Tomorrow onwards we will have the classes like that, I told. Why are you taking that advantage here? Anyway, we will go for this question here. What is the number of the rupees, total amount donated
2401
is equal to rupees 2401. Yeah, then we don't know the number of students here. Let the number of students be X. Some X we'll think. Okay. We think that it is only a number. And each child, so amount each student donated equal to. Amount each student donated. Children, you also can write down along with me. Each student donated is equal to again X. This also is X. Rupees X we can write here. Is equal to rupees X now, right? So totally X rupees is donated by each child. Total amount is 2401. Therefore X multiplied by X, actually this two all are coming as X only for me. This is multiplication symbol, so I'll put it as a star mark.
So you can put Y for the students and number of rupees.
No, not like that. It is X into X. I'll put a star in between for multiplication symbol. That is X square we say. I told you in the beginning of the lesson, X square of X is denoted as X square like this. The number 2 is written over the letter like this. That is all equal to 2401. That means X into X is 2401. Now let us write this X into X. Okay, let it be in the color 2401. We should be able to write as space now. 2401. When we write as a pair, how do you get this one? 2 plus 4, 6, 6 plus 1, 7. Okay, it is 7. So it cannot be divisible by 7. It cannot be divisible by 3, not divisible by 2, not by 5, not by 7. 7 3s are 21, 30, 7 4s are 28, 21. I think 7. By 7 we can divide this. Yeah, I think so. Let us divide this one by 7. 2401. I'll divide, insert a tabular form here. Here I write 7 and here I write 2401. When I divide this one by 7, 7 3's are 21, 30. Here 1 is left out here. I mean 21, 3 is left out, 30. 7 4's are 28, 2 is left out, 7 3's. again by 7, when you divide, 7, 7s are, 7 4s are 28, 6 is left out, 7 9s. Again, let us divide it by 7, then 7 7s. Okay, now, what is given here, all these, of course, all these number, all these boxes are not required, I'll cut them. Delete rows. Right. So now 7000, this is equal to 7 multiplied by 7 multiplied by 7 multiplied by 7. So if I make into pairs here, one pair here and another pair here, is it not? So I am getting two different pairs here. So I can say it is 7 into 7 into 7 into 7.
So 49, sir.
So 7 into 7 I will take as the square root here. Therefore x equal to
49.
X equal to 49.
49.
Square root of this
14.
2401.
49, sir.
That's correct.
49, sir.
So how many students were there in the class?
49.
Very good.
49, sir.
Correct, correct. Leave. It is 2401. Okay, 2401, it is equal to 49. So in the class there are 49 students. So you can see the problem here. Now you can see, oh my god. Now, could you see the whole board here now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
This is the question here.